Hi, this is COMP1010 at the University of Manitoba. I'm Dr. Celine LaTulip, and in this video I'm going to talk to you about variable scope and state variables. So, variables have scope, and what that means is that they have areas within a program where they are actually in use and can be seen and have influence, and then parts of the program where they may not be available or used at all. And so we're going to talk through that and what that means. So there's two types of scope, global or local. So variables declared at the top of an active programming script before the setup function, those are global variables. They're permanent variables in the sense that those boxes of memory are created and they exist the entire time the program is running through all of the iterations of the draw being drawn every time, every 60 times a second. Those boxes in memory just stay there until the program closes. And that's true whether those are global variables or global constants. And so they can be used inside any of the functions. They can be used inside of setup and inside of draw and inside any other functions that might be created. So variables that are declared within two curly braces inside of a block of code, inside of a function, those are local variables. They're temporary. So in this example, the B here is set up, is created, that a box in memory for B is created inside the setup function, and then something is assigned to it. And then as soon as the program hits this curly brace, that box that holds B, it just disappears, it's gone. So B is only available inside of here, okay? So they have variable local scope, and so they have a very small amount of time during which they exist, and then they disappear, and they can't be used anywhere else. So B is inside of setup. We couldn't use B inside of draw because it doesn't have, it doesn't exist here. All right, so when we reach this curly brace, any variables that were created within that block of code just disappear. So you can think of this as what is created in braces dies in braces. All right, so let's have a look at this. So in this program, we have int x and it has, in this program, int A is created here, it's assigned 50, and it exists through the entire program, okay? So we can use it here, we can use it inside setup, we can use it inside draw. And then here, B and C are local variables. So B exists after we create it here, and it only exists for one line of code. C exists inside draw, it only exists for one line of code, and then it disappears. Right, so let's go and look at a real example. So we're going to look at our follow the mouse example. So we've already seen this example. We'll run it just so you see. This is the example where we have the red dots that are getting bigger and then small and then bigger again. Okay. And what we're going to do is we're going to look at this global variable diameter and see what happens if we change this and made it a local variable. So if we comment it out up here, you see suddenly processing says, wait a second, what's diameter? I don't know about diameter. So if we create it here instead, int diameter equals 50, then we can run this and see what happens. And what we see in this example is we're still drawing, it's still following the mouse, we're drawing red circles, but the size of the circles isn't changing. So let's look at the code here to understand. This is happening because we're declaring this variable inside of draw, and it's being declared and destroyed every single time we draw the frame. So this little, this line of code here is actually adding 1 to 50, so it's 51, mod 60, so it's still 51. And this is just, it's every time it's generating 51 and it's drawing a circle diameter 51. And then we get down here, we delete that, we come back 1/60th of a second later to do it again, we create diameter, we create it as 50. So this is no longer acting as a state variable, it's acting as a local variable, and it's not allowing us to know the history of what happened before. We can't keep what was done during the last draw cycle because we're recreating this variable every time. So that's not good. That's not how we want this to work. We actually want this to be a global variable. So I'm going to go back and put that back in place. Okay, what happens if we actually create it in the setup function instead? So there's a couple ways. So we could just do this. We could create it up here and we could initialize it in the setup. We could say diameter equals 50 and we can run that. And this works just fine. So most of the time it's kind of a choice. Creating it up here and then initializing its value in setup, that's two lines of code instead of one. It's up to you if you want to do this. Sometimes this is necessary. So if we wanted this initial diameter to be dependent on the width of the canvas, then we would want that to be in here. Now you might be wondering, what happens if we have a global variable and a local variable with the same name? And that's a really good thing to investigate. So we have diameter as a global variable, and if we put it in also as a local variable, and we initialize it to say 30, we're allowed to do this. And I want you to think for a second about what you think is going to happen. So let's actually just get rid of the thing that changes the size of the circle. And so we're just going to draw a circle. So the question to you is it going to be 50 or is it going to be size 30? Actually, let's make it quite small just so that we can see the difference. So you have to make a prediction. Do you think the global variable wins or do you think the local variable wins? Ready? All right, let's look. Ha ha. It is small. That's a small circle. And that is because local variables will always be used if they are the same name as a global variable. Okay, so generally this is something you don't want to do because it's just confusing to have two variables with the same name. And so you don't want to do this. So let's take that out and run it. And now we're back to using our global variable, which is a diameter of 50. Okay. So let's get rid of that and let's put our changing diameter code back in. Okay, and so let's do one more example. Let's change the color of the amount of redness in this ball over time. So let's set up another global variable. So let's call it int red val. All right, and let's set red val initially to 0. And then in here, we're going to use red val instead of just always having it be 180 worth of red. And then we're going to change this over time, just sort of the same way we change diameter over time. So red val equals red val plus 1. And we don't want this to just go up to a crazy amount of anything beyond 255, because any number beyond 255 here just doesn't make any sense. It's meaningless. So we're going to mod this by 256, which means red val will always be between 0 and 255, which is the range we want for a color input here. So let's have a look at this. So now what we see, is as we go along, we're getting redder and redder, and then it got black. And we're getting redder and redder, and then it gets black. And redder and redder and redder and redder, and then it gets black. Okay, so those are state variables. They keep memory over time, and they're really useful when you're programming. All right, so in general, if we need to use a variable in both setup and draw, then it needs to be a global variable. And if we need something to be able to change and to be able to remember what it used to be and change it over time, then we need it to be a global variable. If you only need a variable inside of a function and you don't need a history of it at all, then using a local variable makes sense because you're not taking up a box in memory that exists the entire time the program is running when you don't really need it. All right, so I like to have a metaphor to think about things. And so a metaphor for global versus local that I think is useful is to think about being a student. And a global constant that is true for and useful for you as a student is your student ID. It exists for your entire university career. It stays the same. It never changes. It's accessed by your professors, by people in the registration office, etc. So it's used all over the university. It's global. And it's constant. A global variable is like your university GPA. It's used all through your university career, and various different people need access to it, like the registrar's office and so on, but it changes over the time of your university career, so it's not constant. A local variable you can think of as like your current grade in a class. It's changing during the term as you do well or do poorly on different things. But other classes don't really know anything about your grade in that class. And a local constant in my class is like your team number. It stays the same all semester long. You're on that team all semester long. But it's relevant only to my class. Other classes don't need to know or care about your team number in my class. It's a local constant. Okay, so we're going to often use the term state variables interchangeably with global variables. And that's because global variables are usually helping us keep track of the state of the program. So you can think of this as what's happening. This is information about what's happening in your program, like what's the diameter of the circle? Where's the ball? What's the score? Is the game over? How many enemies are there, etc. So you can think of lots of things where during the time of a program running, you need to keep track of something over the whole time. So in Follow the Mouse, the diameter was a state variable. And global variables generally are state variables. So the draw function in processing will use the state variables. They'll find out what's happening by checking the state variables, but they might also change the state variables, update them in order to make something happen differently in the future. All right, so global state variables, just remember they're always going to be located at the top of the program outside of all of the blocks, and they are visible and usable inside all of the blocks. They're only created once, and then they exist. Those boxes of memory exist until the program is ended or exited, then those boxes in memory get destroyed. And they're called state variables because they keep track of the state of what's happening in your program. And they can be state variables that can be changed, or they can be state constants that can just be set once and can't be changed. All right, that's it. Thanks for watching.